traveling around Amsterdam. Spending 3 or 4 days in Amsterdam is a great idea for a short holiday. Amsterdam is quite small, but there are still a few things to see, and on a summer day, although you have to be cautious, you shouldn't dress for cold weather. As the saying goes, there's no bad weather, just bad clothing. Each day can quickly change from glorious sunny skies to a bit of rain at any time, making it essential that you wear a light jacket at least, even in August. It doesn't matter where you are in Amsterdam, you'll find beautiful landscapes. The canals are really something special, lined with trees and boats. They have a calming aroma and can relax you instantly. We actually hired a pedal boat, which seemed like a good idea, but it's really not easy at all. 1 hour on those boats and you will be sweating like a dog. But generally, it's really relaxing to be on the water. You can walk around the center easily. A lot of people rent bikes, and there's a constant ringing of bells as they fly around, but I don't think it's necessary. They say that the old Amsterdam was originally just the width of the central station, and taking any of the streets that come off from the station is a nice walk. You can get some good affordable food at La Place on Rokin. It's like a market. We had some Thai food and that was nice and spicy, and went back another time for some fish. It all tastes really fresh and the quality is good. It's full of local people and everything is in Dutch, which can be complicated, but they speak English. I saw a Spaniard trying to order 2 coffees in Spanish. The vendor was so confused, bless her, as he repeatedly said he wanted a corto and gesticulated. He was a bit stressed. It seems like everybody speaks English to a ridiculously high level. They also seem to have a sixth sense in knowing when they see you, if they have to say hello in English or Dutch. The Dutch are lovely people. One of the customs that they have is eating herring. They eat it raw. There are stands on the street. I wasn't sure if I should try it. I was a bit scared, but, well, I asked for advice, and the woman asked me if it was my first time eating herring, which scared me even more. I ended up with a herring sandwich with pickles and onion, and frankly, I don't know what I was worried about. It was great. It tasted extremely fresh, but not too fishy. Very tasty. You can try the Indonesian food too in many restaurants. You can ask for a complete tasting with little dishes, so you can try a mix of everything with a lot of contrasting flavors. An interesting experience. Close to La Place, you'll find the floating market on Single, bringing another lovely fresh aroma, probably better in April or May, but you can buy a few tulip bulbs to plant at home. If you're looking for more shopping, around the corner from Single, there's 9 Straat, the cleaner, fancier side of Amsterdam, with luxury shops, chic bars and cafes, and around the corner you have the Anne Frank Huis. I wasn't particularly excited about it because I thought it would be boring, but in fact, it was interesting and quite enjoyable. Around the centre, there's an almost permanent smell of cannabis, with the famous coffee shops on each street. A lot of people won't like this, especially if you are not expecting to find it, But I love the centre and the red light district, especially when it gets dark. It's interesting, a bit funky and kinky, different, free. There's that smell of marijuana and the red lights coming from the sex workers' doors. For some reason, I wasn't expecting the sex workers to be so good looking. It's all a bit different. You can smoke joints, eat space cakes, be careful with the space cakes, or go to a smart shop and buy some magic truffles for a stronger, weirder experience. We took a day to visit towns around Amsterdam, Volendam, Zaanschans and Ina. Delightful, all of them, and perhaps even nicer than Amsterdam itself. Volendam is a town on a huge lake with gorgeous and colourful houses that will amaze you. The harbour is full of boats and wildlife. It's a lovely little town, and next to it is Ida, also quite charming, but too small. You can try some great cheese, but it was a bit disappointing after Volendam. Zaanschans is the most interesting of these small towns, I think. You get those nice houses, beautiful canals covered in green moss, you have big lakes and the windmills. Also, the beer in these places is much cheaper than in Amsterdam City, where, in fact, I didn't drink any beer. In Zaanschans, I asked for a Heineken, and the barman, jokingly, looked at me in disgust and said, "I'll get you an Amstel. Heineken is for tourists. Amstel is much better." But I really didn't mind. The windmills are gorgeous in the countryside. It's very relaxing. There's a shop and you can try different types of cheese with mustards. The chocolate also is outstanding. Our last day in Amsterdam coincided with Gay Pride or Euro Pride. It was a bigger celebration than normal and quite different too. They partied on the canals in boats, in the canals swimming, through the streets with rainbow confetti floating through the air. I have a lot of good memories from Amsterdam, but I don't think I'll ever forget the man in drag singing Aerosmith's "I Don't Wanna Miss a Thing" in a very strong Dutch accent.